Where we camp by the tea houses, so let's take a look. So here we have our field, all the tents. If you follow me, you'll see the hot water has just arrived. This is what we get when we get into camp, so that we can wash our feet. It's incredibly important we look after our feet every day. So we wash them, powder them, put our trainers on for the evening, so they're allowed to breathe. So moving on, see the tents set up next to each other. Here's Heather. We'll actually take you on a tour of one of the tents. We won't go into one of the girls' tents, let's go into mine. Come this way. Come on in! So we've each got a one-man tent, or two-man tents for one person, so it allows us to spread out, as you can see. So we've got a mat that they've given us, which is fantastic, so we're allowed to put our kit on. That helps us because it allows all our batteries and electronics not to touch the floor, so they stay really, really warm overnight, and otherwise they'll get drained. And we've got our own mats and our sleeping bags, obviously, and the rest of the kit laid out, wash kit, etc. So very, very spacious, fantastic sleeping in, and we'll sleep in this all the way up to base camp. Let me come on out. Tip it up, don't want any chickens inside. So let's go around and we'll go and see the cook area and then where we eat. And we may even show you the toilet. You can come and actually come and say hello to our Sherpas. There's only one in here at the moment, he's just setting his tent up. This is what the tent looks like when it's a mess. Just setting up, sorting himself out. That's Pasang. Okay, so moving over. So all the way through until we get to wild camping, we actually camp next to these tea houses, which is fantastic. Allows us to eat inside, allows the cooks to cook inside, and we can use the toilets, etc. So let's go on. Now come on in. So this is the cook area. This is sort of place we're eating in every evening. So we bring the food from the cooks into here, allows us to stay inside out of the cold, and just a fantastic situation really. Get some pads, etc. So actually camping is not as hard as you think. It's glamping as we say here. But obviously when we get to wild camp, we'll show you what a wild camp looks like. It's totally different. So hello and welcome. This is my first evening video blog. Yesterday we drove in by vehicle from Kathmandu to Shanje at 1100 meters. So today is our first walk. We walked from 1100 meters up to 1920 meters. So 820 meter height gain, but roughly about 2,500 meters of actual ups, with all the ups and downs that there were in between. Following a deep river valley with beautiful waterfalls on our right and on our left. We actually crossed the river twice on suspension bridges. Had lunch at a place called Tal, which is right by the side of the river. So fantastic day, really, really hot weather. Actually drained quite a lot of us because of the heat, near 30 degrees. Tomorrow we're heading up higher, and obviously the higher we get, the cooler it'll get.
There's a rhythm and rush these days, where the lights don't move and the colours don't fade. Leaves you empty with nothing but dreams, in a world gone shallow, in a world gone mean. Sometimes there's things a man cannot know.
So this is our third camp at the end of our second day of trekking. What a brilliant day. Woke up with views of Manaslu, walked through beautiful forest, walked along a road with the most amazing views, and finished the day with views of Annapurna too. Great team, everything going well, being fed well, everything is just magic.
Claire everyone. This is day three of our actual trekking for our attempt on an unclimbed peak, Nar Phu Peak. It's been a great day. We left Koto early morning, and we're now in Lower Pisang. It was an amazing day, amazing scenery. The team's working really, really well together, which is great. You know that because of all the sharing that's going on. This morning it was shared as to who was wearing clean pants this morning. That was me and Heather. It was revealed that James is wearing no pants at all, so he's going commando for most of the trip until summit day. That's because he didn't want to chafe his dangly bits. Brian then announced that his dangly bits he hadn't seen for ages, so it didn't matter whether he wore underwear or not. So that's been the day. It's been a fantastic day. The support crew have been fantastic as well. Amazing support crew. Sherpas have been fantastic, and I'm really looking forward to tomorrow.
Today's been a fabulous day. I've no idea what day it is or the date, but today we've walked from Lower Pisang, as Catherine would pronounce, to Nawal. There's a 5-star hotel here, so one just had to go and get showered. It was compulsory. We've had an excellent day. Catherine has paced us fantastically up the hills. I think we've done about 30,000 metres and we didn't one stop for breath. It was fantastic. Very exciting day for Heather and Catherine tomorrow. Clean t-shirt day for Catherine and clean pants and socks for Heather, pushing the boat out. What more could anyone ask for? The team's working well and so far everything's going fine. Tomorrow's only a half day, so I think it'll be breakfast in bed and then a little bit of a lie-in. Anyway, it's afternoon tea soon, so I'm going to go. Being very well fed, beautiful food. So that's it.
Okay, it's the fifth day of trekking and we've arrived at the intermediate camp, which is where we are now. The views behind are Kangla Pass, which we will hopefully be going up to the day after tomorrow, and that will take us to base camp. But today we left Narwhal and we walked up a very steep ascent, making about 700 metre in total, so a really tough day. Obviously we're gaining a lot of altitude as well, so a real, real toughie. Everyone's feeling really good though, considering, and our camp here is just the most incredible place. We're properly in the wilds now, so we're off the Annapurna circuit. There's no tea houses, there's no villages anywhere near here, so we're literally wild camping with epic views of the Annapurnas, which are that way, and of course the pass up there as well. So it's been a tough day but a really good day, and we've got a day of rest tomorrow, so we shall hopefully see that'll bring us all fit and ready for the next day, which is the epic Kangra Pass climb, which is going right up there.
Oh well, in 5 years' time we could be walking round a zoo with the sun shining down over me and you, and there'll be love in the bodies of the elephants.
Good afternoon and welcome to intermediate camp. Thought that as we're now off the Annapurna circuit, which is all the way down there, and we've been off for 2 days, I'd actually show you how we wild camp. So if you walk with me, we'll show you the tents. So we have the tents set up in a long row here on the ridge. Everybody's got their solar panels out, charging all their electronic gadgetry. Walking slowly because we're at 4,330 metres. And down here we have our toilet tent. The rest of our team sitting, some of them washing, some of them writing their journals, and again all charging their kit. And let's walk up to our mess tent. Do we have a place to wash our hands? And then in here you'll see quite luxurious, our 6 seats sitting down, all set up ready for our afternoon tea. And I don't know if you can see behind you, you can see our cook tent, which is where all the guys cook up the amazing food for us. We won't walk over there because it's too far. And then what we do is we'll pan up to our route. Tomorrow we're scheduled to have a rest day because this is our 6 day walking in, so we're going to have a rest day. But actually, if you look up towards Scree Line, that's actually our route for the day after tomorrow.
Oh, it was fun.
Why did you choose to come on this Unclimbed Peak expedition?
I think it's becoming increasingly more difficult to go to places where nobody's gone before. And obviously there's a lot of attraction to the bigger mountains. But for me, personally, it's going to, you know, peaks where no man has really tread. And that was the allure, really.
All through our bodies and love, love, love. All through our minds and it be love, love, love. All over her face and love, love, love.
It was a few things, actually. First, I love travelling in the mountains. It's just such an amazing experience to be in the mountains. Also, what really appealed to me was the fact that it was an unclimbed peak. To be able to stand where no one else has stood before and trek where no one's trekked before, it's very hard to resist. So that was probably the main factor for me in terms of why. Also, travelling with Brian again. I travelled in Ethiopia with him last year. He was a great team leader, and I had complete confidence that the expedition would be extremely well run and a lot of fun.
Why did you choose to do the Unclimbed Peak expedition?
I won it in a raffle.
Well, I do an expedition every year, and last year I did Elbrus, and I met Brian, where he was guiding two clients, and there he told me of this expedition this year. He'd already done one last year in 2013, and it sounded like a great opportunity to do a once-in-a-lifetime trip.
Just kicking back with you, and if you love, 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 all through our bodies, and love, love, love.
Earlier this year, I was looking to do Elbrus with Brian, and then he sent out an email about the Unclimbed expedition. He sent it to the people we went to Ethiopia with last year, and Catherine and I decided to do it together.
We're a great team. I really believe if anyone can get us to the top, Brian will be able to. Really great people have gelled really well, and I'm pretty confident at this stage we're all going to make it as a team. I've loved the walk on the Annapurna circuit, the amazing scenery, but this is probably the best bit, being in the shadow of the Annapurnas. I just can't believe the scenery. What an amazing privilege.
Ooh.
So good evening. This video comes from base camp. We're now at the just by Kangla Pass. We actually set off really early this morning, gained 1,000 meters straight up, and then dropped 100 meters over a 1 hour traverse to get to where we are now. The snow was so deep still from the storms that they had a couple of weeks ago that we had to ferry some of the loads and help ferry the loads because the mules couldn't actually get through the snow. So they dropped the loads off at Kangla at 5,350 metres. Now we're at 5,200 metres. So it's been a tough old day. The snow's about 2.5 to 3 foot deep outside the tents. So putting the tents up, we've had to dig platforms, and just walking between them you fall right up to your knees and sometimes up to your waist in holes. So it's been incredibly tough. Everybody's in their tents. We're going to actually have dinner tonight in our individual tents because it's a bit dangerous going out, and everybody's a bit shattered, quite a few headaches. So we're hoping that the rest day tomorrow will help us. We're also going to do the puja ceremony tomorrow. We'll probably look at using the crampons and ice axes and just do a little traverses just to get people used to putting their crampons on. But shattering day. Awesome views from where we are. We can see our summit and see the route up the glacier. It's a long, long route, probably going to take between 12 and 14 hours to get there and back. So it's going to be a long, long day for summit. But it's great actually being able to see the summit from here and the rest of the Tudors. So that's it from me tonight. I'm going to get in my sleeping bag and try and get warm, and I'll speak to you tomorrow.
Welcome to our base camp at 5,200 metres. We've just finished our puja ceremony, so you can see all our kit laid out here. So this is basically blessing all of the kit we're going to be using on the summit climb. So our double boots, our helmets, ice axes, crampons, jumars, harnesses and all the other metalwork. So this ceremony took place. We erected the prayer flags. These are the prayer flags that we actually bought in the Buddhinath in Kathmandu, the holy place there. So they've come full circle to here. So that's happened this morning, but let me show you the rest of the camp. So normally this camp is actually just rock, but because of the snow that fell a couple of weeks ago, because of the storms, there's 3 to 4 foot of snow here. So it's heavy going. So here we have the cook tent. So I'll quickly open it up so you can see our guys at work, getting our lunch ready. Come have a quick look in here. Here are all the guys cooking in here. Mankaji, our main cook, and there's all his helpers doing fantastic work here. So we'll zip this back up, keep the heat in. Okay, so we'll work our way up through all the tent platforms. Fasang Sherpa, he's our main man, he's our main guide. And then Dorje Sherpa. So both of these will be leading up the main summit that we're going to do. And there's some helpers here. You see how far they've dug out. They've dug 3 foot down, put up the mess tent where we're going to be eating. So far we've eaten out in the open. And actually last night they brought the food to our tents, which was spectacular. So now they're going to put up the mess tent. But let's walk on and see some of our actual sleeping tents. Perfect timing. Catherine popping out of her tent here. And we have James's tent up on a little platform and Dawn's tent in the distance. And what we do is walk up to my tent so we can see where the toilet tent is. make our way up this real slope. I have my tent over here and Pasang's tent in the distance there. And then over here you can just see the roof, I think, of the toilet tent. And in a direct line with that is actually our peak, Nar Phu Peak, with the glacier to the left of it. So it's the one with the triangle top. So that's what we're going to attempt in 2 days' time. So today is a rest day, and we're going to do some training with crampons and ice axe and jumars, and then tomorrow is a complete rest day before we go for the summit. I hope you've enjoyed the tour of base camp. Thank you. Before summit day, everybody looking rather nervous. The summit behind and the huge hanging glacier that we've got to get over somehow. So this is us. Just to prove I'm here as well. Hello. So we'll go up the peak, and hopefully next time you see this banner, we'll be on the summit. Is that right?
So, as the director of Expedition Wise, why did you choose to start providing Unclimbed Peak expeditions?
That's a great question. Obviously there are lots of expeditions out there, things like Kilimanjaro, Everest Base Camp, but since I was 8 years old, my burning desire has been personally to climb an unclimbed peak and to walk where no one's walked before. And so after doing the first one last year, we decided to open it up to members of the public to come on unclimbed peak expeditions, and deliberately choosing trekking peaks rather than climbing peaks, so more accessible to people who've done high altitude treks before.
How do you know the peaks are actually unclimbed?
Well, that's always a tight one. You never actually know until you get to the top, hoping not to find any prayer flags on the top or a toilet being built by somebody. So you have no complete knowledge of which they're unclimbed until you get there. I think you have to do as much research as you can and then hope for the best when you get up to the top.
How do you go about actually finding the peaks that are unclimbed?
Well, the Nepalese government, as in the Ministry of Tourism, release a list every 4 to 5 years of about another 80 to 90 peaks that are unclimbed, and they release those and give them names, and that's, we have access to that list through the Nepalese government. The region we're in now is an ex-Maoist area where there are lots of troubles, and therefore a lot of the peaks here were not climbed and actually weren't even trekked in, so that's why we know this region especially is unclimbed by Europeans.
And what type of people do you think is suitable for the unclimbed peak expeditions?
I think because most of them are going to be over 5,500 metres, we try and ask people who have already been to altitude. So they've done Kilimanjaro maybe and got to summit, Everest Base Camp, trekked along the Inca Trail, been to the Alps, but done some sort of high altitude before. Because I think that allows them the knowledge that they can get to those certain altitudes. They've been there. And then it's just asking anybody who's actually excited to be on an unclimbed peak. Often we'll be using crampons and ice axes, which people may have not used before, so we do training with that. But anybody really who wants to be on an expedition, push themselves a bit further and get to the top of somewhere where nobody's been in the history of humanity.
So, second day at base camp, having a day off today. So we've just been packing all our gear ready for the summit attempt. We're going to get up at 1 a.m. We leave just after that, after we've had some breakfast and a cup of tea. Today we sent a couple of the Sherpas up to spy a route through the hanging glacier. There's a hanging glacier that's probably about 300-400 foot high. Couldn't see an obvious route through it, but we spied a ramp to the right of it, which basically goes up about 45-55 degrees. So that's sort of the ramp we're going to go up, and then switches back to on top of the hanging glacier. That will enable us to get onto the top platform and then see how the snow conditions are from there on to the col and up the ridge to the summit. So it's all go now, and everybody's excited and nervous, so we'll see how it goes. Hopefully the next time I speak to you will be after the summit, and a successful one at that. Here we are at the bottom of the glacier, Everybody putting their crampons on, their helmets. There's Heather up there somewhere. So this is the team on top of Nar Phu Peak. Unbelievably technical. Some lots and lots of 70 and 80 degree slopes. Lots of climbing. Unbelievable. We are the first people to climb this mountain. So these are prayer flags that we bought in the Budinas in Kathmandu. And now putting them on the summit of our peak. An unbelievably technical summit. A real mountaineer summit. And here are the team as I fall off the summit. Here they all are. All mountaineers. Woo! 5930 we get. So we're going to go 5930 meters.
Well, I don't know where I'm going to, but are you coming with me?
So, back from Nar Phu Peak. Set off at 3 a.m. this morning, or just before 3 a.m. and got back at 7:30. So 16 and a half hours of climbing. It was much more technical than we thought, with a lot of 70 degree pitches on snow and descending the same way. And we found a way through the hanging glacier by a ramp, which was about 45 degrees and then went up to about 70 and then 80 degrees and then 45 again. But all six of us made it. So it's fantastic, beautiful views from the summit, very, very windy and cold. But a spectacular day, amazing. Another first ascent for expedition-wise for the six of us. So hopefully we'll go back to Kathmandu and talk to Elizabeth Hawley, who records first ascents, and also talk to the Ministry of Tourism so they can write it down as a first ascent. On behalf of the whole team, we want to give you our sincere thanks that without every single one of you, we would not have made the summit.